So basically what I wanted to do was just share five of the lessons from over 20 years of mapping for a whole range of different clients. I would say start simple though, and it's very common for people to want to start by boiling the ocean and just getting completely lost in the detail. You know, you'll have dozens of segments, perhaps millions of customers, but I would start with just two very different people, look at the journey from that perspective. And then by all means, as you begin to develop more confidence and experience, then begin to drill down into as much detail as you have the capacity to reflect in terms of your ability to personalize. The second thing I would talk about, I would really get you to think about, is engaging stakeholders early. Once you've stood in your colleague's shoes and seen what the implications of mapping might be for them, then that's a great way to arm you to go and speak to them and to get them lined up and aligned behind your mapping project. And there's a few things that you really need to think about. A couple of those really often get missed. You know, what's in it for them besides potentially hard work if they're going to change stuff? And what are any red lines? So quite often, for example, we'll find, you know, actually we haven't got any capacity to change the CRM system for the next 2 years or whatever it is. You need to know that and build that into your scope right at the outset. The thing that we find is most important, and that is customer insight. You know, if you haven't got really good, relevant customer insight about how they're feeling about their experiences, then it's just the internal perception of what's going on. And very often that's wrong. Think about the power of emotions and the subconscious. We're all sort of business people, and very often we just think that these are rational things, customer effort, you know, all of that kind of stuff. And we forget how powerful that unconscious bias, first impressions are. And what psychologists tell us is that, you know, our rational mind is a bit like the mahout sitting on the shoulders of a huge elephant. You know, he thinks he's in control, but we know if the elephant really decided to do something else, he'd be in a lot of trouble. And the final point I'd like to leave you with is about KPIs and measures, because all too often, people being what they are, we find companies unconsciously using their KPIs and their CX measures not to drive change, but really to say to their boss what a brilliant job they're doing and how actually they don't really need to change very much at all.